Hello everyone and welcome back to the workshop. We're going to be building up AMT's 49er, the 1949 Ford Coupe, 1/25th scale. It is a 3-in-1 kit. You have your options of stock, custom, and drag. Check out that sweet looking drag car. Gasman logos, red stripe over the hood. That's tough looking. You got the full custom on the box top, and then on the back is a stock representation so you can build it any way you want. This thing is absolutely full of parts. Let's take a look at everything that will be in there. First, we got what I like to call kind of loose parts. We got a steely in the bag and some plastic rod here. So just keep an eye on that stuff when you unbox these. The sprues can be a little thin, so parts will go flying off. In this tree here, we've got a sweet logo here. I think that's a logo. We've got a stock dashboard, very nice looking. Radiator, suspension, seat backs. We got some lap belts. Now, 1949 wouldn't have had lap belts, but a lot of people that restore cars will add lap belts later just for safety when they drive it around town and stuff like that. So if you want to use them, go ahead. We got what looks like a 6-volt battery. We've got our steel wheels here. We've got our differential and drive shaft. So nice tree right there. On this one, we've got some stock custom racing seats. This is part of an engine stand, roll cage, and other small parts. On this tree, we have our exhaust system. Now the stock, if you build a stock 49, will only have one piece of exhaust being used, or you can run the duals on there. You can run no exhaust for a drag. We've got some wheel skirts here, wheel pants, wheel skirts, whatever you want to call them. On this upcoming tree, we've got two hoods, stock and custom. Beautiful stock bench seat, very nicely detailed, nice strong lines in there. Custom steering wheel. These little parts are hood hinges. So we'll take a look under the hoods. Both of them have cutouts if you desire to use the blown engine option in the kit. Yes, in this kit there are two complete engine options. Here's our flathead and a lot of its parts. Don't break off the coolant lines there. Got our belt and pulley system, more steelies, got our intake. So that's a nice representation. Got some body pieces here. Got our air cleaner, very, very small. Got our steering right here, so don't snap that little rod off there. Nice parts on that tree. On this tree is our custom blown engine and custom body parts. Its own belt and pulley, intake, water pump system. Belt. We got some scoops here. So a lot of custom parts. No matter which way you build it, you're going to have stuff left over. Here's the base to the engine stand. We built that same engine stand, I think, in the Victoria. I'm not sure which one. We've got our interior tub here with large pins for mounting that seat. It's got the back seat molded in. Door panels. These are basic family transportation when they were built, so they're not going to be extremely fancy. They were a low price leader, so you could get a car for the family and drive it along. We've got texture on the bottom of the interior tub because it can be seen through the chassis. Got our fuel tank. I like that molding in there, that detail, the frame, the body mounts are all molded in place. Got our suspension. We'll be using a rod to mount the front suspension, and then our interior, that's why this is molded. You'll have to paint that because that's going to drop down inside like so. Then we've got that lovely sedan body, the nice bubbly kind of curves to it. Before, in the 50s, they went with all the edges and the chrome. Just that nice aerodynamic shape. Be careful, these are very, very thin. That's why they have these braces installed. You have that windshield cut through. A lot of times they would mold it as a separate piece, and this one, I do like that it's molded in one piece. Just be careful when you're cutting these parts out that you don't spread that too much and snap that part off. Got our firewall and inner fenders molded in, and then the nice nose, kind of cute looking. Little bug eyes on it. Nice roof line. Trim is very prominent. so we can easily paint that trim. If you're doing a stock one where it would have the chrome trim. We'll switch to the other side of the table. You most certainly have two different engines. We know that because it's got the flathead with parts 36, 37. It's got the custom engine with parts 45, 46. And we saw that they use all separate parts. None of them are shared. So you won't have to worry about running out of parts. And then we got that nice engine stand and the entire manual. Keep an eye on it closely. You're going to want to make sure you do your differences between stock, custom, or drag as you build it. We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 tires. Yes, 8 tires in this kit. Drag tires are beautiful. Racemaster dragster tires with gorgeous pad printing. Smooth. These sand down and look super nice and black wall on the other side. And Big Honk and Firestone directional white walls. Look at this pad printing. I've never seen them do this before on their pad printed tires. I'm sure they have. I don't think I've built a kit with it. Black wall on one side. So these would go with the drag tires or the custom tires. You could put these on the back because they're slicks for a total custom ride. And then also beautiful pad printed wide whites or white walls. And those are printed as well with Firestone logos and everything on there. And they look so nice. The tread's beautiful. Love the tires that AMT throws in with their kits. We get one steel axle to support all the weight, which won't be a problem. We get red glass. We get clear glass. We can see it better. They're identical trees. They are very, very clear, molded well. Red headlight options, red glass options for your custom ride and your stock or drag, whatever you want to use. That's in there. We're still not done looking at parts. Check out these sweet wheels. Looks like the custom ones right there. Nice looking black wash in there. Make them look sweet. Then we've got this chrome tree. Love that grill. All molded open. Put my hand behind that so you can see it. Got our stock bumpers, bumperettes. Got a nice set of custom wheels. Got some wheel rings in there. Stock hubcaps. All kinds of custom engine parts and intake. Look at that custom grill. That's for the cover model. Molded open on that. Beautiful chrome tree. And finally, the decal sheet. 49er. Look at those logos. To make a drag or a race, that's really cool looking. Or if you want to paint this thing gold and red, make it like a San Francisco 49ers if you're a big fan. Got that red stripe, got gauges, clock, all hidden in here. Ford logo for the hood. So we've got stuff that we will need for the interior hidden on the decal sheet. Don't miss it. All kinds of awesome stuff. We'll get in close and go side to side. Let you check that out. And then I am going to start gluing mine together. We will be back in just a moment. Let's take a peek at all the cool stuff and bonus parts we glued together during the assembly process. So we've got the body back here. You can see I've got that all set in there so you can see how that fits together. We'll look at that in a moment. We've got the belt, pulley, and generator system for the flathead assembled here. We can get that painted. We also have our pedals, which will get painted separately from the interior. We've got our rear wheels. Steel wheels on there. I did have issues with all the wheels except for one, with the way they're molded. No matter how gently I cut, that thin edge came out of every single one but one. So 75% out of the four. Since we just talked about that, you can see little lips came out, and I tried to saw it off, and I tried, and it was just so thin that it came off. But that we'll try to blend that in and stuff like that when we put the tires on. We've got our little trophy here. That's what that is, with the base little trophy on top. So I assembled that. We've got the front wheels with our large plastic pins, so be very careful with those. We've got our blower motor, our air cleaner, and our shock absorbers. We'll get all those painted up on that tree, and then we can individually detail them. The dashboard is cut off separately because I'm going to be painting that with the body. I'll paint that body color on my ride. Got that nice front bench seat with the back, and you can see the seam is hardly noticeable if a person wanted to sand that down. I build it as is out of the box unless it's a glaring issue. That's why when some of you, I've literally been cussed out in the comments section for not fixing every little mold line and all this stuff. I build out of the box. That's how I've been doing it for years on this channel, and literally hundreds upon hundreds upon hundreds of builds. So that's what people are used to, and that's how I build. Out of the box, review it as it is, and only fix something if it's a massive gap that I'll look, and then I'll fix it, and then I'll tell you what I had to fix. But mold lines and stuff like that, I leave them as they are. I build them as they come out of the box, pretty much. We got our engine stand here for the second engine, so you can either use the flathead or the modified V8. The modified V8 can be a carbureted or a blown version. Obviously, you can see what I've attached up here. So I will be doing the blown version. That assembles nicely. And when we're all done, it doesn't balance on well. Now I will glue it into place, but that will sit up there like so. And it actually balanced for the first time. So that's pretty cool. So that will sit on its little engine stand. We have the differential and the backing plates assembled. I do have a little bit of a tweak in the mold. I don't know if you can see that. You see all that leaf goes down farther, but all four points glue securely to the undercarriage. So when we get them on there, we'll just bend them in place and hold them with super glue, and we shouldn't have a problem. Got the steering column all set up. Since I'm building the stock car, it has what I'm guessing is an automatic, at least could be a manual shift on the tree, but make sure that that goes out to the right side, the manual says. Our nice stock steering wheel. The radiator is assembled with the nice radiator brace and the mount for that flathead on the back with the holes for the radiator, the water lines. So we'll get our wheels over there. We'll get that over there. Then we can slide the nice assembly over, and it just pushes together and goes together real nice. At first, I thought the chassis was a little cockeyed in there, but it turned out I didn't push the interior far enough in. So if you have that problem, that might be what you're experiencing. The hood, so far, fits on beautifully. Don't think I'll have an issue with that, even with that tree in the way it slides in real nice. The flathead just drops into place. We've got that. We got the oil filter. We got the oil filler. We got the carburation. We got the distributor. All of that you could attach individually on your own. But I'm just going to get it like this, paint it, assemble it, get it ready to go. That should be easy enough to work on. Got our body and chassis. See that nice fit? Fits right in. That interior on the inside, you see that door seam in there? See how that interior piece pushes below the door for a second? If you manipulate it enough, there you go. See how it pops up like that? And then it all fits in. You got that nice lip on both sides. Then it fits in evenly. The fenders fit to the frame. You see how that goes? So when you do that, make sure you get that interior shoved up all the way to the bottom of the windows on both sides, and that's when your body will fit on correctly. So let's pull this out. We've got our rear splash pan, our front splash pan glued on for the stock version. Got our front suspension, upper control arms, and that's pretty much it for the chassis on the stock version. Goes together quite well and seems to be molded straight. The interior needs nothing, it just needs to be painted. And I don't think I even have to cut those pegs out. No, I don't. Front seat sits in there beautifully, so the pegs will just, we'll just put some glue on top of those and set it right down in there. And the body didn't need any work. I didn't worry about sanding anything. I did cut off those braces so I can get the paint in there. But otherwise, we are set to go. So I'm gonna hit the paint booth. We're gonna be building a plain Jane stock 49 Ford, and I'll see you over there. back with an update to see where we are on the 49 Ford sedan or the coupe build. We've got our things going pretty well. I've got my interior done. I did decide to add the lap belts, even though they wouldn't have come stock on a 49. It is extremely common to add belts aftermarket in the modern restoration era, just because of the way people drive and stuff. They want to be safe while they go out for their Sunday cruise. We got the dashboard done, nicely detailed. And the interior, you saw me two-tone those seats like a plain stock sedan. And the interior door panels are all pretty basic and stuff. So we just touched the crank handles and some of the trim with a silver marker. We've got that optional engine all done. I think it's a Cadillac engine, but that's just, I'm only going by that because it says Caddy powered on the decals. So I'm just going to guess that. Maybe it might even say it on the box, but anyways, that's a nice little blown engine. Painted the intake gold colored, and then just everything else that was chrome. Didn't blackwash it, didn't mess with it. Painted the transmission and glued it to the stand. The stand I painted a gold silver. I painted it gold and then misted silver over the top of it. So that makes for a cool little secondary complete engine. And remember, you could have built that with three carburetors on the top too. Got our trophy all done. All I did was spray that gold leaf, left the car chrome, and blackwash the little wreath in the center. And it makes a little V for victory. It looks like a nice little car trophy. It's half the size of the car. Like I said, we got our interior done and did make sure to paint the bottom. We got the chassis done. On my car, I did do dual exhaust. I just felt like putting duals on there. It's an extremely common thing to do with cars, especially, you know, if it's the second, fourth, or tenth owner. They've added lap belts to it later. Could be their 60s. Who knows when this car, you know, but could have come out. We got a little bit of patina on the bottom. Gas tanks get some surface rust. Exhaust is getting some surface rust on it. Otherwise, the car is not totally roached out or destroyed. I did use the trim rings and the hubcaps. When I noted that issue with the wheels, good thing if you use the trim rings, you will cover that up completely and go right against the white walls. You can still tell that I painted the wheels black. I used Mod Podge to attach the hubcaps and the trim rings so that I did not fog or ruin the tires at all. Love those wide whites on this machine. I think they look real, real nice with that suspension. And then, of course, I went with the stock flathead. They just left it alone. They did not put anything modified in it. Now the body is done and ready to go. I've got the headlights mounted in. The headlight bezels just press fit in and I glued them from behind. We got the hood trim on with some super glue, just falls right in. Got that hood logo on. You saw me place that decal on. Got the under hood done. Got the blower motor in it. Got the battery installed. Got the radiator installed with those headlights. And I installed the glass and the headlights with Mod Podge. You can see me do that in numerous other videos, like the LA Dart one just before this. Got our stock taillights mounted on. That's what you saw me using the red marker on. Did all of our trim work. Why did I use a silver Sharpie for the trim and then a Molotow chrome for the side trim? Molotow chrome pens are more like a paint pen. So for covering a very large area like that, it works quite nice. Sharpies allow me to do very fine line work and get in there and do the trim. And from the side, they pretty much look the same. And since I'm not going to be putting any clear coat on this car, it's shiny enough out of the can to pass as a survivor style car, as a car with at least, you know, 20,000, 30,000 miles on it. There weren't any clear coats back if this was an original paint job and they just kind of added duals and lap belts and have been driving it since. You know, that just a regular wax, you're still going to lose some of that shine. So on this one, I'm not going to go for the high gloss. I'm not going to go for the fancy dandy stuff. I just want it to be as it is. I like that look on this particular car. The grill will just glue in gently when we're all done. Fits right in there, and that's going to look pretty cool with that black wash on there. All I have to do is put the interior in the car, make sure I press it up all the way, attach the chassis, put my bumpers on, put my grill in, and we are done with the car. There's no extra decals to add, but that decal sheet is absolutely gorgeous. I debated about putting stuff on there, but I'm just going to leave it the way it is. We are all set. When I come back, we'll have that final. my build, my very first build, and this kit was so sweet that if they reissue it, there is a 100% chance that I'm going to do the Gas Man or these decals, the 49er. Look at that. 100% chance I want to use those decals. Because those, and they even got like a little guy over here. And put that big caddy engine in it. And yeah, awesome kit. First time building it, very, very pleased. Went together and it just makes, I love a workaday car, all right? I love a plain Jane car that the average person can afford and cruise around in. I would definitely never touch a 49 Ford Coupe with the flathead, the sage green, the green that Ford had back then. I would drive this car in original condition with those wide whites on it and the trim rings and just the basic chrome. I would love that. I wouldn't touch a thing except maybe what I did on mine, which was run the duals all the way back instead of a single exhaust, just so that instead of having this super, super quiet car, you had a little bit of a rumble. It wouldn't be a massive glass pack, annoying, get pulled over every 3 feet machine. It would just have a little bit of a gurgle is what I would like. I think this car is beautiful. I think the kit goes together really nice. I highly recommend it. I love that grill. The bumpers go on easy. I mean, the car was a very, very easy build. I did figure out what was keeping that interior from pushing up all the way. The front C shape of the interior where the dashboard goes across was just a little spread. When I put the dashboard in, it didn't fit. It was a little gap on either side. So all I had to do was just squeeze it together, glue the dashboard in, and that cured the issue with the interior popping in. The little pins at the bottom of the interior fit right into the bottom of the firewall. The back pins snapped in and it just clicked right where it should be, and we got it done. So awesome build, very, very easy build too. If you haven't built a model kit in a long time, I know this is the time of year, October, the leaves are falling, it's getting cold outside, people are getting back into modeling. I'm getting a lot of comments from new viewers, and welcome, I love you guys. This is a kit you can get, the 49er, the 1949 Ford from AMT. I will link down in the description where you can get yours on pre-order if it's not out by the time you watch this video. And this is something you can put together, whether you're a Chevy guy, Dodge guy, Ford guy, if you just like model cars that go together fun and have a buttload of options in the box, go ahead. We got our little trophy here. We got our, I'm gonna say, blown Cadillac engine on the side here with an engine stand. We got these gorgeous slicks in the back. That's what I'd love to put on the back of the 49er. And then you got also these drag mat, these race masters. The MH, I mean, those are tight too. So really all kinds of stuff, the red windows, all that stuff. Just build it and enjoy it. If this is one of the first videos you're watching of the workshop, I'll explain this, even though everyone who's been watching a long time knows this. I don't build show models. I also don't worry about mold lines and all that stuff and sanding them off and perfect paint finishes. I build pretty much the parts that I get out of the box is what I put together. I throw paint on them. I invest 2 days or less in a complete build from start to finish. I get these done nice and quickly. I video them for the crowd, and that's what everyone understands and likes about the channel. They don't come here for, you know, you have to build it this way. I say I'm going to show you some how-tos, how to get the paint on quick, how to detail an engine, how to paint little things to make them look nice, how to do trim work fast and easy and inexpensively. That's a how-to. I don't do have-tos. You don't have to build my way. You don't have to use my paints. You don't have to use my decoration methods. I just want you to see what you're going to get out of the box and how it can turn out if you want to do a nice, quick, fast, and fun build. As always, thanks to all the long-term viewers. Welcome back to modeling, all the folks getting back into it for the winter season. If you build for fun and just enjoy yourself, you're going to stick with the hobby. If you build and stress yourself out and worry about all the tiny details, I bet you're going to burn yourself out after a year, if even that, and you're going to leave the hobby. Just make sure to enjoy it your way, whether it's show builds, whether it's fast, fun builds, whether it's just assembling kits and hardly ever painting them. I want you to have a good time. That's all that matters. Thanks for watching the workshop. We'll see you at the next review.